Hello, this is Turker from AUDAC. In this video, we are going to talk about new CAYMON PSQ108 Power Sequencer configuration and dashboard widgets. PSQ108 can be configured and controlled in combination with the latest release of AUDAC Touch. With Power Sequencer, you will have fundamental features like voltage and current draw reading and surge protection. But most importantly, you will be able to control how you want to power on or off your system using any third-party devices or through the widgets on a dashboard you created in AUDAC Touch. For third-party control, ASCII controls are already available on the product page. In this video, we will focus on how to set power sequencing feature for delayed on and delayed off and available widgets on a dashboard you created in AUDAC Touch. First, let's configure PSQ108 for delayed on and delayed off operations. In this example, we want to control power of a system consisting of a switch and Luna F. Later, we will focus on how to control delayed on, delayed off, or individual relay with AUDAC Touch and NCP105. Before going any further, you can add PSQ108 like other AUDAC devices, and to control with NCP105, make sure to configure a commander device in AUDAC Touch with the same IP address. You can refer to the video about commander function if you don't know yet how to do this, but we have already prepared some commands in the commander for the PSQ108. Let's check power sequencer settings of PSQ108. I want to configure first how the PSQ108 will react when powered on. So we want delayed on and save it. Next, relay delay times. I can choose between enabled, disabled, or let it stay at last state. So for the first delay, let's say it's network switch. I want to exclude it from the sequence, so click on disable for both delayed on and delayed off. So I can choose the disable and exclude it from both sequences. The next device on relay 2 is the Luna F. Let's choose enable for both and try to keep the sequence time delay times as short as possible. I know that the booting for Luna F is roughly 40 seconds. So for the, let's say, amplifiers on the other relays, wait for the Luna to boot. Let's say that those are 40 seconds of delay for the delay on time. Notice that when there's a change in the settings, save button will be highlighted. You need to click on that button to implement the sequence changes to the device. Let's go to this control menu again, and let's see how the device reacts for delayed off first. As you can see, relay 1 is excluded, so it's still on. So let's make a delayed on now. See, after Luna F is powered, the rest is now waiting for 40 seconds. Suppose you want to control the power with a wall panel. For example, NCP105. We have already prepared some commands in the commander for PSQ108 and show them already in dashboard example. Let's configure NCP105 to control PSQ108 with those commands. Let's say button 1 is for delayed power on. And button 2 is for delayed power off. Button 3 is for relay 8 power on. And finally, button 4 is relay 8 power off. Don't forget to click on save button once you're done. And CPU 105 is now ready. Let's try relay 8. So power off, power on. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and it inspires you with ideas on applications. So, delayed off. Thank you.